Our second scripture lesson is taken from the book of Colossians, chapter 3. Listen for God's word. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which you were called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and admonish one another, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. This is the word of the Lord. Well, counting today, five more days and it is upon us, right? Thanksgiving. Turkey, mashed potatoes, gravy, corn, stuffing, and stuffing ourselves. Football games, basketball games, board games, relaxing with family and friends. It's a wonderful holiday. And this year, I'm really looking forward to it. Marlene and I are headed down to Atlanta. The whole family will be headed down there to visit with our daughter, Johanna, and her husband. But too often, right, we're so caught up in the festivities and who's coming to dinner or where we're going to be headed for dinner that we forget that Thanksgiving is, well, for giving thanks. An activity that none of us is guilty of overdoing. It's really quite incredible, isn't it, that we have a whole national holiday set aside for such a thing? And sad how few of us really take advantage of it. In fact, it's a source, constant source, really, of amazement to me that we're so blind to the fact that we are not, as we often imagine ourselves to be, independent creatures making our own way through life. We take for granted all the forces that keep us alive, and we boastfully think and talk about being self-made people. It's almost as if we strut through life as if there were no one else we need to recognize as the source of our strength and power. An appetite, not just for pumpkin pie, but for giving thanks to others and to God. Now, like our family, I'm sure yours too has a number of traditions that you follow on Thanksgiving. At the Chapins, after the table has been stacked high with turkey and mashed potatoes and sweet potatoes and peas and corn and gravy, cranberry sauce, several different salads, side dishes. After all are seated, before Dale gives his way too long dinner prayer, we go around the table and each of us shares something that we're thankful for in the past year. It's an interesting exercise. And strange to me that we never seem to anticipate the moment, such that almost every year we end up stumbling and bumbling, trying very hard to think of just one thing we want to express. It almost always ends up kind of being an awkward and embarrassing and very brief minute or two. And so for those of you who who may have a similar tradition, I want, with your help, to prime the pump by spending our time this morning going around the table, allowing you to give thanks for some of the things, some of the people that you have been blessed by this past year. First, we're going to look at or take some time to thank those inside the congregation. And then maybe you might think about some of those outside the congregation who have blessed you, to whom you want to give thanks. And then finally, to God, to whom all thanks belongs. So let me begin our thanksgiving by thanking you. I know I run the risk of forgetting someone, but I'm willing to do that because one of the things about you that I am most thankful for is that you are a forgiving congregation, especially towards me. So let me begin. First, I want to thank all who make our worship services possible. Bulletin preparers, ushers, greeters, liturgists, communion preparers, communion servers, those who offer prayers during our services, Brian, our sound guy back there, those who work the visuals, candle lighters, choir members, soloists, instrumentalists, Kathy, John, and all worshipers. On this Sunday before Thanksgiving, please accept my genuine thanks for your time and energy and presence and skills to make worship here at Christ Presbyterian Church what it is, a wonderful, welcoming, warm experience of God's grace and mercy each Sunday. I'm thankful as well for everyone on our staff who truly love this place and appreciate the meaningfulness of serving a congregation like this with one another. I want to thank all who are involved with our children and youth. Marlene, Aaron Drews, volunteers at the Children's Chapel, Greg, who takes all our children's photos along the wall outside there, our childcare folks, parents who see to it that their children are here on Sundays, anyone who is engaged in nurturing our youngest members, from greeting them in the hallway to being a part of some program here at the church. I'm grateful to you for making our children a part of our CPC family. I want to thank Abe Lee, our youth director, and the parent team for youth. Paul Culp, who teaches the youth Bible study almost every Sunday morning. The volunteers, the parents, those who drive our youth from one place to another, who go on their mission trips, who see to it that they get to the Super Saturday events that they sometimes kind of talk about. All our volunteers, I want to thank you for working with our young people. I want to thank those who are commission chairpersons, those members of those commissions who do the nitty-gritty work of a church, those who serve on special teams, task force, like the vision team or the refuge group, the Castlescape group team, those who served on cleanup day here at the church, those who've taught a Faith Cafe class, led a small group, helped in the office, took a Sunday at the servery making coffee, tea, hot chocolate. Thank you. To Gene Cowden, Rachel those who have organized and overseen and corralled volunteers for the road home, for the volunteers at the road home themselves, overnight hosts, hostesses, meal preparers, folks who've spent time with the children of the road home families, those who have moved equipment, beds, and all kinds of other things in and out of the church, those who have set up bedrooms, who've washed laundry after the week is over, at the end of a road home week, all those who have helped make our campus a home for those without a home this past year. Hooray, and thank you. Procession and deacons, wedding coordinators, those who've made visits to shut-ins or made calls on those in the hospital, shuttled someone in need to a doctor's appointment, you have my gratitude. For those engaged in meals at Luke House, tutoring students at Mendota Elementary, those who've offered support on Undy Sunday or the Giving Tree and other special mission giving, to those of you engaged in our ministry with internationals who serve on the board or are here Friday nights or Saturday night meals or are part of the international spouse group, you have my thanks, my appreciation. To all who volunteer, who give time, pray for the church, offer your skills, your energy, your presence to any of our ministries or mission projects, let me offer today on this Thanksgiving Sunday my thanks. You are what make Christ Presbyterian Church the special place it is. Okay, now that I've begun to prime the pump, I haven't exhausted it. It may sound like it, but I have not come near exhausting the thanks that we can give as a church family. And so I'm going to take the risk of turning on this microphone and making my way down onto the floor to ask some of you to give expression first to people in the church to whom you are thankful, and then maybe we'll get to people outside the walls of the church for whom or to whom you are thankful. And then finally, our thanks to God who stands behind all our gratefulness, as we read this morning. So, let me head down. Are there people, or are there activities, are there things here within the church that you are thankful for? I'll give you about 10 seconds to think of something, and right there, Maggie's already.
I have an easy one. Can you hear me? Yep. My name is Maggie, and I'm very thankful in this year for my new marriage and for Christ Presbyterian for supporting that. Pastor Dale helped Sam and I go through a very thoughtful and comfortable premarital counseling here, and then we had our wedding on September 3rd in this beautiful space. So thanks to all the joy that we felt through the congregation as well in that special time.
Thank you, Maggie.
So my name is Elise Blanchard, and I got really sick early part of this year. A lot of you know that. I actually tried to die, and I didn't quite make it. Thank goodness for that. But I'd like to thank all of those that stood behind me in prayer and in support and encouragement during the 7 months that it took me to recover from my illness. And especially I'd like to thank this guy, because he stood through me, taking me to, you know, 4, 5, 6 appointments every week to try and get over it. Honestly, I view my recovery as a miracle. My doctors did not expect me to be where I am today, off of oxygen and back to work and really doing well. And I really appreciate that this church stood behind me.
My name is Peter Blanchard. The first thing that came to mind was how the folks in this church have loved our kids. We have three kids, and we can always think of something to be thankful for at Thanksgiving because all three of them had birthdays this weekend. Over the last, 32 years since Jonathan was born, so many of you have cared for our kids. And when they show up here with us, you welcome them and show them that they are loved. And I really appreciate that.
Who else?
I have a lot of gratitude this year, but as I look at the wall of our artists, I am so grateful for all of those that are on the arts committee, and for Eugenia Brown and others for spearheading this art show, as well as Barry Sherbeck and others for hanging it, Peter Blanchard for organizing the food, but just for the artists and all that goes into that for us to have this beauty.
Hi, I'm Ruth Strong. I'd like to thank everyone that helped me through my surgery, the rides that I had to my appointments when I couldn't drive, and all of the help and support that they gave me. I'd like to thank John Bowman for being director of our bell choir. I have a great time at this group, and Kathy Otterson for our music director. I really enjoy the music.
Who else has something to be thankful for? I'm going to pass this down.
May I thank you, Dale, and the members of this church who have expressed interest in my sister and her health. And each message is a help. It adds wind under the wings. And I thank you so much for that. And that's within inside here. Also, obviously, outside, the six firemen who worked on her in our living room, the emergency crews, the hospital, as well as the caregivers where she is in the health center now. Thanks to them, and they generally all fade into one face. You can't say enough to each one. And again, thank you here.
So I'd like to say a word of thanks. My name's Clint Naughty Ford. I'm the head of the Connections Committee. And I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you to Cindy in the office, Cindy Banish. She does an amazing job throughout the year organizing parking and room spaces and committee meetings, and she really does it with joy and humor and so much energy. I'd also like to thank Carol Quintana for all the work she does with the building, keeping this place beautiful and working and giving us a place to invite people to. Thank you.
Is it on? My name is David Miewski. I moved from Appleton, and I was looking for a home for this, for myself and our family. And I want to thank this congregation for making me feel welcomed. And yesterday I signed up to be in with a new member class. So I want to thank this congregation for making me feel welcomed.
Is this on? I would like to thank Arlene Lynn. She may be the smallest member of the congregation, but I think she has the biggest heart. And every time I turn around, she's greeting somebody, she's setting up communion with Barb Sorensen. She does all the plants and flowers, and I'd just like to say thank you for the church, ladies.
My name is Susan Kelly. And I would like to, now I get very emotional over everything, you know. But I would like to thank all of you for all the great prayers that go out to our teenagers, and for the Wednesdays group that always meets together, and I just feel a real support. Thank you.
I'm Doug Madsen. I want to thank all the folks who have sponsored children in Rwanda, faithfully sending money and praying for the kids, and it has been a resounding success.
One more.
I have to give thanks for the greeters and the ushers. So often people think that they don't have enough talent or particular ability or enough smarts or background to do something that matters, but there's nothing like walking into church and having somebody greet you with a smile on their face and a few words. I have visited tons of churches, and you simply don't find that everywhere. I think it's a great gift to get up early and dress yourself up and come up with a smile on your face. And I think the session and the what we've had to go through for establishing our priorities under Dale's leadership, to come up with that as a high priority, it's a real blessing.
Okay, Kathy, with your big lady voice. Of course, there is just so much to be thankful for, but I hope that we have kind of primed the pump this morning, and that you'll take advantage of that come Thanksgiving Day and spend a little time, take a little time aside to think through all the ways that you have been blessed and to give thanks. God stands behind all that we have given thanks for this morning, of course, and all things. And I'm thankful to God today for the gift of life. I'm thankful to God for tilting the earth at a 23.5 degree angle to give us the seasons, the bright sun that we experienced this morning through the windows, those seasons that we love here in Wisconsin, for sun, wind, rain, for the love and whole range of emotions that make us truly human. I'm thankful. Thankful for God's love, for letting me and you know of that love and desire to heal our hurting world by sending his son Jesus. I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for God's justice, especially in this time, that one day will make all things right and whole. Without it, I would not be able to stand in this pulpit each and every Sunday, because I know a day of justice will come. I'm thankful. I hope there are ways in which you too are thankful to God. We've all had someone who's helped us this past year, but have we thanked them? Silent gratitude isn't much use when you can speak it. And gratitude unlocks a fullness to life. It turns what we have into enough and more, doesn't it? Turns a house into a home, a stranger into a friend, a meal into a feast. It brings out the very best of ourselves. Thanksgiving is what we were designed to do. So live into that this Thursday and every day, and thank you for listening to me and one another this morning. Let us pray. Gracious God, when we pause, it is no surprise that we find in the Psalms all this praise and thankfulness to you. When we think about all that we owe to you and others for our lives, for as rich an experience of life as we have, for help and hope, for all that's been given to us, we can't help but respond in gratitude. We pray that this Thanksgiving season might be one in which we are made more and more aware, not only of how dependent we are upon you, but how in that dependence you provide all that we need. So we offer ourselves to you in Jesus' name with thanksgiving. Amen.